Bitcoin Cash hard fork, Binance, and Coinbase are accepting it. This is a weird turn of events. Coinbase rarely does this, but hey, maybe they're a big fan of Bcash. Let's get into today's video.
So in addition to Coinbase, Binance, Ledger, there's also BitMEX, and now there's a new website that you can check out. All these links will be in the description below. It is forkmonitor.info. It's sponsored by BitMEX, and currently its first project will be Bcash and Bitcoin for its future hard forks, but there is a biannual event. Bitcoin Cash has two hard forks every year. And if you're a fan of crypto, you've been around for the past couple of years, you understand that a hard fork is usually just a series of updates by developer groups to make the current crypto better. And sometimes there is a dispute between some of these developing groups, as is the case with this one. And it seems with Bitcoin Cash, there's going to be a little bit more spotlight on this fork in particular due to the disputes. So just as Bitcoin quite some time ago had that hard fork and Bitcoin Cash came out of that result, a similar set of events may take place on November 15th, and it's going to be at 16:44, 40 p.m. UTC. So for everybody who has Bitcoin Cash before, they will get the Bcash hard fork pairing. And this means there's just gonna be free money generated. So if you have a lot of Bitcoin Cash, which it's over $500, so you gotta have at least a couple thousand for it to really make sense, because usually the hard fork is worth less than the actual coin that's getting forked. So some people are predicting it's going to be 10% value, 20% value. Let's just say it's going to be 10% to make math easier. If Bitcoin Cash is $550 at the time of the fork, which it's currently around that price, it did have a rally from $473 to $570, $580, around there, over $100 increase due to the hard fork news and then the support of all these major exchanges and then a couple other things and just generally hype. It did fall from the 570s to 550 now, and now Ripple's experiencing a little bit of hype. So there's been some developments with XRapid. They planted a new office in Dubai, which was funny because one article said that was the sole reason that Ripple is going to the moon. I was like, that's bullcrap. But generally speaking, there was some developments, and as soon as Ripple and Ethereum were going head to head, people started going further. They started investing because they were waiting for Ripple to beat Ethereum, and it did for quite some time until Ethereum went back on top. But Ripple was the largest altcoin in terms of volume for a little bit. It still is up 10% today. It's in the 50s. Both Ripple and Ethereum around $21 billion volume. A lot of money. Bitcoin Cash isn't too far away. And this being the 6th today, you have less than 10 days to prepare, because some exchanges will be shutting down BCH deposits and trading before the hard fork. And usually this is in preparation for the actual fork to take place, because some money may just get lost if it's being sent during the actual fork. So exchanges rather just shut everything down and then worry about it later. So for those individuals who will receive the Bitcoin Cash hard fork, if you have $1 million worth of Bitcoin Cash, as some millionaires out there might, you're going to become a very rich man or woman in the next 2 weeks when you're trading. Some people will sell immediately. In other circumstances, in the past, we've seen fork experience a significant pump due to the whales. But even if you're holding a minimal amount, 10% of $550 is $55. Was interrupted, but Bitcoin Cash, $550, 10% of that is $55. So if you've got a couple shares of Bitcoin Cash, you're gonna have a couple hundred. If you've got a couple hundred thousand, you're gonna be experiencing thousands or tens of thousands of free cash. Hey, you can buy your Maserati or a new Rolex. We're gonna do a quick interruption of today's sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by Free Coin Hunt. Thank you guys. So what is it? For everybody who's searching for bounties and airdrops, this is the site to get it. So if you check out the website, you're able able to find all the recent bounties and airdrops, the more that you're able to connect, you're going to get free coins fast and easy. It's not a lot. It's similar to an altcoin faucet. The more coins you hunt, the more coins you're going to receive. And in addition to these tokens that are being produced, you can get some FCH on top of that. Around 1,000 FCH is worth $1. There are certain amounts of F energy being generated. It happens every hour. This is after you sign up. Some of these coins can be redeemed into other more powerful altcoins. There are various niches, anything from privacy to social media networks to Wi-Fi to gaming, anything you can think of. The website and more information is in the link in the description below. Again, a great amount of appreciation to this company for helping me pay off certain amounts of debt. Stay safe with your altcoins. Figure out the best ways to earn. And if you can find an efficient coin through this system, awesome.
And we're back for more information.
A lawsuit against Coinbase was dropped by a U.S. judge. This was from when Bitcoin Cash was listed on Coinbase. If you remember, it was strange to say the least. A lot were saying insider trading. And here it says, in July, Coinbase released the results of an internal investigation, finding no evidence of insider trading or inappropriate investing by employees and their friends and family. Just 2 weeks ago, it was reported that on recent insider trading, that lawsuit against Coinbase was being dropped by the U.S. judge, who claimed the company had done all it was capable of to prevent market manipulation. Some people were up in arms with this. Others were saying that the U.S. judge was bought off by Coinbase. Okay, I'm not actually sure if anyone is saying that, but I'm pretty sure it could happen. And Coinbase is now valued at $8 billion after their Series E funding has completed. So that's pretty cool. And this is during a period where Bitcoin is at $6,300. So if Bitcoin were to head up to $25,000 in the future, if that would happen, I'm just saying it'd be a very interesting period of time where Coinbase could easily surpass $100 billion valuation, and it's growing. But currently, I just checked, Bitcoin is at $6,463.72. It's up by 59 cents. Ethereum's number two at $218. XRP Ripple is at 54.6 pennies, up 9%. Bitcoin Cash is up 12.62%. It is surpassed the 500 mark, so it's only been a couple of hours since I was doing some other things, and now I'm finishing up the video, and it's at $623.48 to complete it. It's at $10.875 billion market cap, so that is pretty crazy. And most of the trading for Bitcoin Cash is currently happening on BitForex. BitForex, that's rather kind of weird. And then we got OKX, which I'm not really a big fan of. And then we have Binance and Bitfinex, and a little bit later, Huobi and another Binance pairing. The 24-hour volume is pretty astounding as well. It's nearly $1 billion. It's at $955 million currently. Bitcoin Cash is currently at a two-month high. It's still a long distance away from where it was originally listed in a couple of thousands. So the hard forks that we're discussing here are two different implementations. It's Bitcoin ABC and Bitcoin SV. So we're going to go in details into the fight now, which side you should choose. Okay, to be quite honest, it's just best to observe. And if you're investing, invest in both sides. Why not? Bitcoin ABC has been perceived by some as a subtle declaration of war within the developer community. It is the new software release. The software includes a suite of upgrades, including a smart contract feature that would support atomic swaps, a way of trading one cryptocurrency for another without traditional exchanges. And while many crypto projects are excited about the idea of interoperable coins, some big names in the Bcash community don't agree with the changes and have, no surprise, been very vocal about it. Leading the opposition is Mr. Craig Wright himself. Bitcoin SV, on the other hand, scraps Bitcoin ABC scripts for its own. It's pushing up the block parameter to 128 megabits, while Bitcoin Cash's block size is currently at 32 MB. Bitcoin SV release announcement is taking a dig at Bitcoin ABC's developers, and here is what it says. Bitcoin SV is intended to provide a clear Bitcoin Cash implementation choice for miners who support Bitcoin's original vision over implementations that seek to make unnecessary changes to the original Bitcoin protocol. After Mr. Vitalik Buterin decided to call out Craig Wright as a fake, some people were going on various sides, and Vitalik's really saying the Bitcoin Cash community should not compromise with Craig Wright to avoid a split and should embrace it as an opportunity to conclusively ostracize and reject him. Despite all this, though, Wright is far from alone in supporting the end-chain implementation. Anyways, if you'd like to read further in-depth, all the links will be in the description below. And that is that for tonight. It is 1:23 in the morning. Peace. See you guys in the next video. Bye.
Thanks so much for watching today. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'm in the middle of effing nowhere right now, so I'm going to try and find my way back home. I'm lost. See ya.